It's Wren. So I'm back with another tutorial today, and this is the same look that I had in my grad haul video, and I told you guys I would be doing a look for it. So I absolutely love how this look is, and it is actually inspired by HRH Collection, and the owner of that channel is, her name is Alexandra, and she did a video recently talking about her summer makeup and hair and like kind of like what she did for summer. So the look that she did was just very glowy and summery and had very nice like pinky corally lips. So I just did a video kind of using the products that I have and like just going over and like recreating the look just with products that I owned. And I actually did have like one product that was the same as hers. So I mentioned all of it in the video. And so I really hope you like it, and I'm going to put a link to her video in the description bar so you can check out her video too. So just let me know what you think. I hope you like it, and have a great day, guys. Bye! So what I did first, HRH Collection, the owner of it is called, her name is Alexandra, and she did not mention if she used a primer or not, but I did use a primer on my face. I used the Smashbox Photo Finish Light Foundation Primer, which is really great because it doesn't have, it's oil-free, so it doesn't make your skin overly oily in the summer, which is awesome. And then what she used for her foundation was the Stella Illuminating Moisturizer. And I don't have that product, and she said it has very low coverage, so I don't think I'd be purchasing it either. But what I use is the Sonia Kashuk Radiant Tinted Moisturizer SPF 15. And I just got this at Target because I wanted to try out a new tinted moisturizer, but I didn't want to go out and spend a bunch of money and like get one that I'd end up not liking. And this is only like $10, and I actually really like this. It gives great pigmentation, it feels really nice on the skin, and I've gotten so many compliments on my skin since I started wearing it. So I like this a lot. I don't think she used any concealers, but I did. For dark spots and like redness, I used my Maybelline Mineral Power Concealer. And then for under eye circles and then some little pimples and stuff, I used my Revlon Photo Ready Concealer. To set all of that, I used my MAC Fix Plus, which really helps with your foundation not bleeding during the day, especially with tinted moisturizer because it tends to have less of a hole on your skin. So I just use this to set it and just use a stippling brush to get the spray in there, and it's really great. And then I just applied some of my MAC Mineralize Skin Finish Natural to any areas that I didn't want to get overly oily, like my T-zone, and then on my chin and my neck. So to start off, she started by using a bronzer all over her face just to get some color. And the bronzer that she used was the Chanel 10 de Soleil. And by the way, I just have all these things like written down on a little notepad so I don't forget the names. But I'm going to be using the NARS Laguna Bronzer just all over. Well, not all over, just like on the areas. Add some color to my face, is what it looks like. Just a nice brown bronzer. And I'm just going to take a fluffy brush like this one, just kind of pat it into the product. And I'm going to focus this mostly on my temples and on the hollows of my cheeks just to get some color. And what this is really nice because it also gives you a bit of a glowy color too. So it's not just doing contouring, it's also giving your skin a nice glow. I really like how it works. So you want to focus on the temples, onto your cheekbones, onto the sides of your nose to kind of slim it down. I like to do it on my jawbone and my chin as well. And then you also want to do it on your forehead and to your hairline, just so it looks more natural and blends in. So now we got all over a little bit of a color. And this is a really great bronzer. I love it so much. I just used it, I talked about it in a haul, and I've been using it for a few days now, and I really like it. And so, then the next product that she uses is the MAC Gold Deposit, which is kind of like a shimmery, bronzy powder. And instead of that, I'm using my MAC Margin Blush, which is just kind of like this rosy gold blush, which is just so pretty for summer. I think it's amazing. And so I'm just going to take that same brush that I just used and pat it in there, and I'm just going to put this onto my cheeks. So I'm just going to bring it all the way up to my hairline just to get some of that bronzy glow. And this is going to give a nice glow to the cheeks because this is a bit, this is a frost blush by MAC. So it just have like a bit of a shimmer to it, like more like sparkly shimmer, but like a glowy shimmer. And then next she uses the MAC Cheche La Mer, which I think is like a mineralized skin finish powder, like one of like the really light shimmery powders. And something that I have close to it is this powder from, Physicians Formula. And it is from their powder palette Mineral Glow Pearls. And this is Translucent Pearl. So it's just a shimmery, kind of like nice highlighting powder. So I'm going to use a fan brush, just like this. Just kind of fluff it into the product. I'm going to sweep it on the tops of my cheekbones. Just like that. And I wore this at my graduation and I got a ton of compliments from everybody saying like, oh, your skin's so glowy. And it's such a nice product. I absolutely love it. Next, what she did was she used her same, that highlighting powder on the inner corners of her eyes, and she didn't do actually any eye makeup, but I'm going to do a little bit of eyeshadow just using, some kind of cream eyeshadow. So first I'm just going to prime my eyes, and I'm going to be using my Urban Decay Primer Potion in Original. You're not going to put any color onto your lower lash line, so don't worry about putting any primer down there. But what I'm going to be using is two different NYX Jumbo Eye Pencils. So first I'm going to be using the shade Yogurt for an all-over color, and it's just going to give a kind of like a nice shimmer, just kind of like a nice glow to your eyes. And then I'm going to be using Cottage Cheese as the highlight, which is like a shimmery white color. So I'm just going to take this one and put this all over the lid. And you don't really want to bring it past the crease, you just want it on the lid. That's really the best spot for it. So now that you got that, oh my, it exploded. So now that you've got that, just go in and kind of like pat it in so it's not too harsh looking, so it doesn't look like you just made a bunch of lines on your eyelid. Just gonna use my finger to pat it in. So now I'm going to use Cottage Cheese, and I'm just going to line this onto the inner parts of my eyes, like down here, and then on the inner corner. Just go ahead and line that. And you can line it as much as you want, depending on how much of the color you want to show up. Okay, so now I've got a kind of like a nice little glow in the inner corners. I'm going to go in and put just a little bit more into the lower corner. So now it just gives you a nice little glow to your eyes. They kind of like look a little bit more glowy, and it looks just so natural. It doesn't look like you're wearing like a ton of any eye makeup. It just gives you kind of a nice bit of like a glowy color. So I really like that. And the next thing that she did was she used a brown eyeliner for the top lashes, just because it was a little more natural. So I'm going to be using this one from Rimmel because she didn't know the name of the one she used. So I'm going to be using Rimmel's Exaggerate Waterproof Eye Definer, and this one is in Sable. And so first I'm going to tightline my lashes because I love to tightline my lashes. And then I'm going to line my eyes, and then I'm going to do some winged liner. So first I'm just going to go ahead and tightline them. And for those of you who don't know what tightlining is, it's the tightline is that line. It's like the waterline, but it's like for the upper part of the lid. So what I like to do is kind of lift the lid up and put the eyeliner in there, close my eye, and just line it. And this is what works for me just because I've been doing it for the longest. Okay. So see how it kind of like makes your lashes like just like a little bit thicker? That's really what tightlining is great for. And now I'm going to go back and I'm going to line my upper lash line and kind of just make it kind of messy and just very like smoked out, I guess. So I'm just gonna use my mirror, do that. Watch me as I dance under the spotlight, listen to the people screaming no more, more, cause I create the feeling that keep them coming back. And try not to get it onto like the inner corners of your eyes, just so that the highlight kind of stays there. So now we got that in there, it's kind of messy. And I'm just going to go in and just smudge it a teensy bit with my eyeliner smudgy brush. Kind of soften out that line a little bit more. I would also use my finger to do the same technique. However, the NYX eyeshadows aren't very, they need a lot of like hold to them. So I don't want to like add any extra smudging to the color. So that's kind of softened out. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a gel liner to do the little wing on the end. And what I'm going to be using is this Smashbox Cream Liner in Midnight Brown. And this is a color that I usually use on my eyebrows, but I wanted to use this as my actual eyeliner today. And dab this angled brush in there. And then this is going to be just like a very softened little line. I'm just going to pat it into the skin and then pull it in. So it just makes like a very soft little natural wing. Now I've got that done, so I'm just going to take another little brush and kind of soften it in. Okay. So next, she applied a cheek stain from Tarte, and I've never actually tried it, and I'm not sure where it was. I think it's something from Sephora, but I've never seen it before. And it looked like it was kind of like a peachy, pinky color. So I'm going to be using my Sonia Kashuk Cream Blush in Petal. So it just looks like that. Just kind of like a corally, pinky color. And I'm just going to use my finger and going to dab it into the blush. And what I'm going to do is just pat it from the apples of my cheeks up to my temples. And you also want to kind of rub it in with like circular motions. Okay. So you can just go back and add a little more color if you need it. So now you're just going to fill in your brows. So first I'm just going to tidy them up with my brow brush. Just going to make sure they're all together. And then I'm just using a CoverGirl brow pencil that I have forever. Just filling the brows. And this step is totally optional if you already have darker brows. But if you have lighter brows and you just like them to be like a little bit neater, you can just go ahead and fill them in. Because I have a bit sparse brows and then I have like little spaces and like to make them all finished. So now she uses mascara. And she uses CoverGirl's Lash Wash Mascara, which I actually don't really like that mascara. But the one I'm going to be using is by Maybelline and is the 1x1 Volume Express Mascara for lengthening. And so the technique that she does is she focuses mostly on the outer corners. Like she does one basic coat and then she goes back with multiple coats onto the outer corners. So I'm going to try to do the same thing for you guys. So just do one coat. And I'm also not curling my lashes. Do one coat all over. Oh gosh. Finish with this coat, and I got some mascara down here, as you can probably see. So I'm just gonna get that out with some concealer. And this is the best trick that I know for getting like mascara and stuff off your face: is putting concealer and then wiping. Because then it'll add a little bit of coverage to that black spot and also remove the color. Okay, so keep this handy just in case it happens again. So, I did that first coat. So now I'm going to go back and focus again on the outer corner. And it's good to wait just a few seconds for the mascara to sit from the previous coat. Okay, so now I'm going to go to the other eye. A don't know why, but I'm in so many issues lately with, like, my mascara brush just getting in my eyes, and then this whole thing with the mascara underneath becoming a problem. It's becoming slightly annoying. Okay. So now I'm going to go back and do one last little coat of just these outer lashes. Okay. So see how full they look now? So you can do a little bit on the lower lashes. She likes to do a lot on the lower lashes, but I don't really like to do it as much down there just because I think it makes them look a little bit fakey, at least for me. So I'm just going to do a teeny bit of it. Okay, so now your eyes are all done, and we are almost done with the looks. The last thing you have to do now is the lips. So for the lips part, she does two different lip looks, and one is a nude look, and then one is a very vibrant, corally pink look. So I'm going to focus on the second one that she does. And the first thing that she does when she's doing that is she applies a lip gloss. It's kind of like a primer and a base, and it's from Bobbi Brown, and it was one of like the little like paint pots in Calypso Coral, which I actually tucked at Sephora, and the only carrot now is a lipstick. But I didn't want to buy the shade, so I'm going to just be using a basic little lip gloss from this kit I have from Sephora, which is just a big just case of colors that I got for Christmas. So the lip gloss I'm going to be using for the base is this one right here. Very pinky peachy one. Just use my finger and put it on the lips. Make sure it's very even and you get a nice deposit of color. So this alone actually looks really cute, and you could just leave it like that by just putting down that base and then not adding the lipstick on top. But I'm not going to add a lipstick, and so I actually have the same lipstick that she used, because after I saw the video, I fell in love with this product and I was like, I have to get it. So when I went to Sephora, I got it. So this is the YSL lipstick in number 30, and it's just like a pinky, peachy, corally shade. It smells like apricots, tastes awesome. So you just put this right over the lip gloss. So just put it on. And this is a very creamy consistency, like the cream that sticks from MAC. But it's a nice matte color, there's no shimmers or anything weird to it like that. It just comes out very creamy and nice like this. So this is the final look. So I'm also going to be putting a link down in the description bar of the actual video so you guys can compare the videos. And I absolutely loved her look. And so this is just my basic interpretation of how I would do it with my products. So I really hope you like it. I will talk to you all soon. I'll be having more tutorials up soon. So have an awesome rest of your week. I hope you like the tutorial. And please let me know if you plan to try it out or if you plan to try out HRH Collection's look as well. So have an awesome day, guys. Bye. I'm that monster in the mirror, the headliner, finisher, I'm the closer, winner, best when I'm